So, what we have studied in last lecture, that is loops. So, these are three different types of loops. For loop, while loop and while loop. While loop is called as entry time condition checking loop. Do while loop is called as exit time condition checking loop. Okay, so in that, only difference is that if first time the condition of while loop is false, then body of while loop does not execute it. But in do while, if first time condition is false, then also single time or once the body of do while get executed. Otherwise, there is no difference for same condition. Whatever may be the result of while loop, same result is given by do while loop for the same condition and the same body. Clear? So, next, you can make same. For that, using while, we can solve some different logical problems. For example, what is the end result? First we discuss what is the end result. So, enter any number. This is the first thing. Enter any number. Okay? This is one message on the console. After that, user enters some value. Suppose value is 1, 2, 3. Press enter. So particular value is assigned to some variable. Now what is the result? I want the result that sum of digits in that number. What we want to display? We want to display sum of digits in that particular number. So what is the sum of digits? Sum of digits is equal to, in that number, is equal to 6. Clear? So, what is the problem statement? Take any number from the user and find its digits sum and display it on the console. Clear? If user enters only 1, 2, then what is the digits sum? 3. Okay, if user enters 3 times, then it is 9, whatever may be. Clear? So, concentrate on what are the constant part and static one. This is a static, this is variable that is changing as per user's requirement. Whatever user enters the number, again, sum of digits is equal to, this is constant or static part, and this number is a variable part. Clear? Basically, first find what is the output of your program. What is the requirement that is called as the, that is the requirement of the end user. First take the whatever may be the requirement of the end user and then code the program. Okay. So what is the end user's requirement? Enter any number and what he wants? He wants sum of the digits. Clear? This is our problem statement. So we can solve it by using while or do while. No problem. Okay. So first, what is the thinking? Thinking is required. Okay. How we can solve this problem? Okay. So that is the pattern. Search the pattern. Okay. Actually, we take two examples prior on depending on the while loop. First is the how to print hello 10 times on the console. And what is the second? Sum of the first 10 natural numbers. Okay, you can convert this program into, again, take any number from the user. Suppose the user enters 20. So make the sum until 20. 1 to 20. Okay, not static. We can make it as a dynamic program. Clear? So, first concentrate on that. So, what is the... Okay, let's start writing program. This is not the good thing also. Okay, just write the code first. First, find the pattern. First, find the logic. First, find the way of thinking. Way of reasoning. Clear? And then you can code. It requires only 1-2 minutes to type the code. No doubt. But thinking requires... It is not a time bound. Okay, 1 hour it is... there. No. It requires time. Okay. So, What we want to think on this problem statement and find out the logic. First, I start write program from void main, include your header files. Next of that, what is the statement, constant part, edit, enter any number, don't miss, enter any number, okay. After that, scan it, %d, comma, ampersand of num, that is variable name, so declare it, integer, num. After that, clr, scr, that is clear screen statement. Next, what is next? Sum of digits is equal to, that is constant. But before that, we have to find the steps, how to calculate sum of the digits. You can use loop. Okay, so what is the basic use of loop? If there is some pattern, okay, some part is constant, some part is variable, changing. But there is a sum pattern, there is also some pattern, then we can use loops. We can repetitively execute the same statement. Same means some difference may be there, but it is also having some pattern. Particular pattern, that is number is incremented by 1, 1, 1 each step, like that. Or same steps we want to repeat 4 times, 5 times, 6 times, like that. Okay, then we can use loops. Clear? Okay, so for that we can use while. Before that we find the logic. So how we can calculate the sum of digits? Any idea? Take any example, manually first take any example, suppose 1, 2, 3, this is a number used, entered by the user. So how to find common statements so that, that is like after executing, we get the sum of digits. For that, thinking requires lower level, in first standard, how we can think. Okay. This is also your first standard of C language. So think at that level. What do we do if we are in first standard and we want to make sum of these digits in particular number? So what we want, what do we do? First separate the 3. Okay. And that 3 is stored into some variable. Suppose sum is a variable. So first store 3 into the sum. And sum is a variable, so what is the initial value? So we want that, decide that we want to store this 3 value into some variable, and initial value of some variable is 0. So 0 plus 3 is stored into sum. Okay, so what is the next step?
Sum is equal to sum plus 3.
Sum is equal to whatever may be 3.
Sum plus 2.
Now sum is 3. Next step, what is the next step? So find a particular pattern. What is next step?
Sum is equal to sum plus 2.
Next step is think lower level. Second step is discard that number. Discard first digit 3 from the particular number. And what is the number remaining now? 12 is the number remaining. Okay. So next step is first step. So number ahe. Given number from that first digit, that is 3, separate. So I write here, separate first digit in num. Num is the variable. So what is the first step? This is the first step to separate first digit in particular number for first iteration. Lakshya. Okay, we can find the pattern. How we think? This is our thinking. So first separate the digit, first digit from your particular number. So separate it and store it to some variable. Okay. Suppose this is a some variable name is what? R. R is a reminder. That is okay, or some number. So R, store it into R. And that number is add with the initial value of sum, that is 0, and store it into some variable. That is second step. think lower level, otherwise programming is so difficult. Okay, pattern finding is most important. What is the third step now? Whatever may be the number, three number is already separated and added with the sum variable. So discard that number digit from that number, okay, and whatever may be the remaining number. So what is the remaining number? 12. Okay, so what is the third step? Okay, delete first digit from your number. Okay, now what is the remaining number? Store it into again number variable. These are the three steps. Okay, and follow these steps again and again, repeatedly. Clear? So just manually, what is the, this is your entered a number by user. First step, separate the digit from the number. Separated digit is equal to R. Store into some variable, suppose R variable. Now R is equal to 3. Next, make the sum. For first iteration, sum is equal to initial value of sum plus that R, that is 0 plus 3, that is 3. Second step is done. Third, discard the last or first digit from that number. So what is the remaining number? 12 is the remaining number. And store to the same number variable, num variable. Num is the initial number. Okay, so store into same number. Repeat that steps, these three steps, again and again. After that 12, what we want to do again? This is our original number. Now it becomes original number. Separate the last digit from that number. So last digit is now R is equal to, this is first iteration, second iteration. So what is your first, this is your number, now separate last digit. What is the last digit? 2. And store into R. Now make the sum is equal to sum plus R. What is the initial now sum value?
3.
Plus R. R is 2. So what it becomes? 5. Second. Third. Now what we want to do in third step? Delete last first digit of this particular number. First digit. Okay. So what is the first digit? 2. So